हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू LICD लेक्चर नंबर 4A। टुडेज टॉपिक इज वोल्टेज एडर एप्लीकेशन एंड वी विल सी नेक्स्ट हाउ टू बिल्ड अ इन्वर्टिंग एडर यूजिंग ओपैम। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक। ओके, सो वेयर डू वी यूज सच अ वोल्टेज एडर और अ समर? So the application is music industry. So let's consider a scenario that you have two musical instrument. One is a guitar played by artist number one and second is a violin played by artist number two. Now these two musical instruments will emit sound and we have two microphones which picks up the sound signal and converts the sound signal. The microphone converts the sound signal into electrical voltage. So the voltage generated will be given to, we need to mix this two music together, the sound together. So we will use a voltage adder, or in the music industry it's called as a mixing stage. So this voltage adder will add these two voltages and basically at the output you will have all of this recorded and given to a speaker where it will broadcast the music of these two added musics together. So particularly in the music industry, adding more or than one music of different type is a common practice. So let's say in this scenario we require more louder guitar and a softer violin which has to be added together, so that here not only we are adding two musical instrument sound together, but we also want to adjust or scale the voltages which are summing up. So basically here voltages means outputs of the microphone, and basically it means in the musical terms to adjust or scale the tone or the pitch of the music. So this means that we have to add a varying factor to these two voltages, and in the music industry we call this process as mixing. So that's what the idea is. Now how do we build such a circuit that can do something like this, that is addition of two sounds together to have a different composition of music? So a simple solution is op-amp. We look into the op-amp and op-amp can give us an elegant solution to this problem. So that's the motivation for studying voltage adders. Now let us go back to a circuit and let us try to build op-amp as a adder. So let us see. So we have our already a circuit is there. So this circuit is a familiar inverting amplifier circuit with a gain minus RF upon R1 with input as V1. Now we will modify this inverting amplifier and make it as an inverting adder. Now let's see how to do it. So we go over here and we take another arm like this and add a voltage. This my voltage will be V2. And if I want to add three voltages, I can have place one more resistor arm like this and place it over here. Okay, now let me label them. So I will label them as V2 and V3. So this will be resistor R2, this will be resistor R3. So this simple looking circuit which you see over here will add three voltages, V1, V2 and V3 as per the resistor values. So let me write over here V1, V2 and V3 are three input voltages. It can be AC, it can be DC also. So basically let us start analyzing now. So before analyzing, let me label certain things. So let me choose another color. So let us consider that the current flowing through resistor R3 is, sorry, the current flowing through resistor R3 is I3, current flowing through resistor R2 is I2, current flowing through resistor R1 is I1. Let us also consider the current flowing into the op-amp terminal, negative op-amp terminal, is I minus, and the current flowing through resistor RF is termed as IF. And also we need to add two more terms, syntax. This is, so this terminal connected to the non-inverting is called as V plus, and this terminal over here we call it as V minus. So that completes our all the markings in the circuitry. Now let us first try to quickly understand what does this mean and how we can apply and get the output expression in terms of the three inputs so that we can build up the adder. So here what we can observe directly is, let me just keep it like this. Okay, so what we can observe from the circuit is V plus is connected to a real ground, and we have just now in the previous lecture we have learned the concept of virtual ground or virtual sort. So via virtual ground concept, V minus also will be at a virtual ground or a virtual sort. So we can start writing this. Okay, so we'll go over here, select a color as black, and we write it here. V plus is 0, which is at the real ground. And basically, our V minus is approximately equal to V plus is approximately equal to 0 volts, and we can term it as it is by virtual sort concept, or we can call it a virtual ground concept. So basically, your inverting terminal will be at a virtual ground, and a non-inverting terminal is at the real ground. Now, let us analyze this further. So from this circuit, can I determine I1, I2, I3? Yes. So what is I1? I1 is nothing but V1 minus V minus upon R1. I2 is V2 minus V minus upon R2, and I3 is V3 minus V minus upon R3. And also we can determine what is IF. IF will be V minus minus V out upon RF. So we can determine that. Also, if we apply a KCL at node number V minus, at node V minus, what we can say? I1 KCL says sum of incoming currents is equal to sum of outgoing currents. So we can write I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to I minus plus IF. So let us start writing this down. So what we can write over here is something like this. Applying KCL at node V minus. So what do we get? So we get I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to I minus plus IF. Okay, so what we can write about I minus in the circuitry? Let us go back to the circuit. Okay, so I minus is the current flowing into the op-amp terminals, and we know that since op-amp has a very large input impedance, the current flowing into the op-amp can be considered almost equal to zero. So we can write over here in the next step that the current I1 is, yeah, so we can write current I minus is approximately equal to zero since op-amp has very large input impedance. For 741, impedance is around 2 mega ohm, and for ideal op-amp it is infinite. So indeed my I minus is approximately equal to 0. Also, one more important condition is this, that is V minus is equal to 0. Now we can add these currents together. So again I repeat, I1 was V1 minus V minus upon R1. So similarly we can collect I2, I3 and IF. So let us start writing again. So we go over here and I change the color to black again, and we can write over here like this. So what is I1? I1 is V1 minus V minus upon R1. I2 is V2 minus V minus upon R2. I3 is V minus minus V minus, V3 minus V minus upon R3. And what is my I minus? I minus is 0 plus IF. What was IF from the circuit diagram? So IF was nothing but V minus minus V out upon RF. So we'll write over here V minus minus V out upon R F. And what do we know about V minus? V minus is at virtual ground. So how we can write this term as? So all these terms, in all these terms, V minus will be almost as zero. So here in this will become zero, and also this will become zero. So the equation will be modified as follows. So again, I select the color as black. Okay, so this will become V1 upon R1 plus V2 upon R2 plus V3 upon R3 is equal to minus V out upon RF. And I can easily rearrange this. So I can write now V out is equal to minus RF. We can write it as a big bracket, minus RF upon R1 into V1 plus RF upon R2 into V2 plus RF upon R3 into V3. So this is my expression for inverting adder. Basically, my adder has expression has come up now. So this is my output expression in terms of the input voltages. Let me just put it inside the box and interpret it. So that's it. That's a very beautiful result, which is showing you all that it says that the output voltage is the summation of the three input voltages, and depending upon how I choose the value of R1, R2, R3 and RF, I can get different weighing factors to add to this inputs. So I can have V out is equal to minus 3 times V1 plus 5 times V2 plus 4 times V3. So we can have a different weighing factors. So this is my output expression for inverting adder. Now why the name inverting adder? Because of the negative sign, and also the inputs are applied to the, as you can see over here, the inputs are applied to the inverting terminal of the op-amp. So that's why the name is inverting adder. Okay, so let us, okay, so output can be interpreted as, let me just take the color and write it out over here. So we can write V out is a weighted sum, so that's very important, is of weighted sum of my inputs V1, V2 and V3. So that's the very first scenario over here. Key V out is a weighted sum of V1 plus V2 plus V3. That means we can interpret it as follows. So if RF upon R1 is not equal to RF upon R2 is not equal to RF upon R3, then what we can say is each input is amplified with a different weight or a scale, so that the given circuit can be called as a scaling amplifier. So that's what I've said before. If R1 and R2, the values are such that the weights attached to V1, V2 and V3 can be different. So if all three are different, we can call it as a scaling amplifier. So this is my first scenario. Now let us go to the second scenario. Let me change the color of my pen to, let's say, green. Okay, so the second scenario is something like this. If I consider, so let me go. The second scenario is, if we consider R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R3 is equal to R, then what do my expression becomes? So let me rewrite this expression, which is marked in the red box. So it will, R1, R2 and R3 are equal to R. So if I rewrite this equation, what I will get? V out is equal to minus RF upon R into V1 plus आर एफ अपॉन आर इंटू वी टू प्लस आर एफ अपॉन आर इंटू वी थ्री. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट स्टेप में वी कैन कंसिडर कीपिंग आर एफ अपॉन आर एज कॉन्स्टेंट आउटसाइड एंड वी कैन राइट वी वन प्लस वी टू प्लस वी थ्री एंड वी कैन ईजली राइट इट एज फॉलोस. अगेन वी आउट इज इक्वल टू माइनस के टाइम्स वी वन प्लस वी टू प्लस वी थ्री. सो वॉट डज दिस इक्वेशन टेल? एंड वी कैन राइट ओवर यर वेर के इज इक्वल टू आर एफ अपॉन आर. सो वॉट वी कैन इंटरप्रेट इट ओवर यर? वी कैन इंटरप्रेट इट द फॉलोइंग दैट द सर्किट एक्ट्स एज अ समर. सो बेसिकली इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द वैल्यू ऑफ आर एफ एंड आर. इट विल एक्ट एज अ समिंग एम्पलीफायर. सो ये वी कैन राइट द सर्किट एक्ट्स एज अ समर. ओके, सो द के वैल्यू विल डिपेंड अपॉन द वैल्यू ऑफ आर एफ एंड आर. वी कैन एडजस्ट इट. नाउ देर इज अनदर सिनेरियो. सो दिस इज माई सेकेंड सिनेरियो. आई हैव माई थर्ड सिनेरियो ऑल्सो. सो लेट मी चेंज द कलर अगेन टू ऑरेंज. ओके, सो माई थर्ड सिनेरियो इज इफ आई कंसिडर ओ सॉरी इफ आर वन इज इक्वल टू आर टू इज इक्वल टू आर थ्री इज इक्वल टू आर एफ इज इक्वल टू आर. नाउ ऑल द रेजिस्टेंस इन द सर्किट, लेट्स कंसिडर दैट ऑल द रेजिस्टेंस इन द ओ सॉरी ऑल द रेजिस्टेंस इन द सर्किट आर इक्वल. सो वॉट इक्वेशन वी विल गेट? वी आर मूविंग इट डाउन. सो या इट हैज कम अप नाउ. सो वॉट इक्वेशन वी कैन राइट ओवर योर? वॉट विल बी द इक्वेशन बिकम? सो इट विल बिकम एज फॉलोज. सो इट विल बी वी आउट विल बी इक्वल टू माइनस सो आर एफ एंड आर आर बॉट सेम सो आर अपॉन आर इंटू वी वन प्लस आर अपॉन आर इंटू वी टू प्लस आर अपॉन आर इंटू वी थ्री बिकॉज ऑल द रेजिस्टेंस आर सेम. सो वी कैन इजली राइट दिस एज वी आउट इज इक्वल टू माइनस वी वन प्लस वी टू प्लस वी थ्री. सो नाउ इट इज वेरी एविडेंट दैट आउटपुट इज अ सम ऑफ थ्री इनपुट वोल्टेजेस. द नेगेटिव साइन इंडिकेट्स दैट इट्स अ इनवर्टिंग एडर. सो योर नेगेटिव साइन मीन्स इट्स अ इनवर्टिंग एडर. सो दैट्स हाउ वी कैन बिल्ड अप इनवर्टिंग एडर यूजिंग ओपैम. सो वी कैन रिवाइज दिस नाउ. सो वी हैव सीन डिफरेंट केसेस एंड वी हैव डन द डेरिवेशन फॉर द ओपैम. इट वॉज एक्टिंग एज एडर परफेक्टली. So this was the circuit and we have three interpretations that it can either act as a scaling amplifier or it can act as a the summing amplifier or a averaging amplifier we can also say. So when we can call it as an averaging amplifier, let me just check. Yeah, so we can have one more scenario over here. Let's consider it as follows. Let me change the color. Okay, so in this expression, in this case number two, if we add one more constraint that if we add over here, so if we write over here, if R1 is equal to, let me just take this over here, R2 is equal to R3, oh sorry, is equal to R, and we will add one more constraint. So the output expression we already know that how it will become. It will become as V out is equal to minus RF upon R into V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now we can concentrate over here. And further, if we can write as follows that let me change the color. So now if we can write in this expression, if we consider if further if RF upon R is equal to 1 upon n, where n is the number of inputs. So in our case, the number of input is 3. So let's consider n to be 3. So if we consider RF upon R as 1 upon 3, then what will be my V out given by? So my V out will be given by, so let me change, V out is equal to minus 1 upon 3, that is minus V1 plus V2 plus V3 divided by 3. So what does this expression indicate? This expression indicates that the op-amp is behaving like a averaging amplifier. So averaging amplifier. So if we have four inputs, it will become, we can select RF upon R as 1 upon 4. It depends upon the number of, inputs, and we can see that whatever number of inputs are there, that factor is divided and that becomes the average. So if we are applying V1, V2 and V3 as 1 volt, then the V out will be the average of the three input voltages. So I guess this was the last topic for this last interpretation. That is, we have four interpretations of this equation. The first one was acting as a scaling amplifier. The second was the circuit acts as a summing amplifier. The third was it was acting as a plain inverting adder. And in the fourth case, it was acting as a averaging amplifier. So that's the advantage of op-amp. And also, we have to consider that whatever applications which we are considering, the op-amp is working in the linear region. So op-amp over here is working in the linear region. That's extremely important, and this is using a negative feedback. So then only negative feedback. So only then we can apply the virtual short concept. So that's it. So we have completed our today's topic. That was a voltage adder application and op-amp as an inverting adder or a summing amplifier, or we can also call it a scaling amplifier or averaging amplifier. So it has lot many functions. So this was the circuit which we have discussed. So that's it for today's lecture. Next time we'll see another cool application of op-amp. Until then, have a good day.